Best WOD of the week. This is a partner workout. It's two parts, part A, part B. Part A, this is my partner. He's going to be working for 1 minute, and I'm going to be doing the other set of movements for 1 minute. We're going to go back and forth for a total of 12 minutes. You'll have 4 minutes to transition, and then you'll do the other station for 12 minutes. So, part A, Keith Station. He's going to start with burpee box jumps. Chest to deck, kicking his feet in. Box jump, full extension, jump down. Now there's some good technique here, but you gotta be careful with this. You don't wanna be sloppy. You can jump right down, right into that next rep, jump in and right into your box jump if you're good. Don't do it if you're not good at box jumps. So after a 6 burpee box jumps, he's then gonna do 6 plate ground overhead. You guys know the deal on this. Butt down, eyes up, nice flat back, top of the plate touches, and then you press out overhead, doing that nice little spin move with the plate. After your 6 ground overhead, you're gonna get down on your butt, and you're going to do 6 V-sit taps. His feet should be off the ground, but a way to make them a little easier, you can put those heels on the floor. That would be the fitness version. Now, after he does his 6, 6, and 6, that plate's gonna go on the floor. He's going to stand up, both feet on it, and he's gonna do reverse lunges. Your reverse lunges, you're gonna do as many as possible in the remainder of that minute. We want you to get to the reverse lunges because that's the scoreable portion of this WOD. So if you're not getting those reverse lunges, you have to scale accordingly so you get there. Keith is going to count his total reverse lunges. Say he got 8, he would jot it down on the floor. Beep, 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 timer goes off, and then I go with my set of movements. All right, so Keith would do 1 minute of his work, and then he's pretending to be me now. So I'm gonna go in my working minute. I'm gonna start with 4 squat cleans. Bar's gonna start on the ground, and we have to go in a full squat. Elbows come up, and then we go back down for 4 reps. Remember, use full extension of those hips, and make sure that bar stays nice and close to the body. After that, we're gonna do hand release push-ups. Hand release push-ups means we're gonna go all the way down. Your hands have to come off the floor. We're thinking about a super tight core. Think about pushing those toes away from you because we want your body to stay in one straight line as you do them. Guys are doing 7 for our X, girls are doing 5. We're then gonna stand up and we're going to do hang power cleans. 8 reps for our X. The bar has to stand all the way up first. Hang position above the knees. Power position means we do not need to go down to a full squat. We're gonna have nice fast elbows coming around the bar. And then with this station, the scoreable portion is going to be ball slams. Again, same thing, just like the ground overhead, butt down, eyes up, pick that ball up overhead, slam it down with all your might. You're going to do ball slams for the remainder of the minute, counting your reps. Again, that's the scoreable portion. So say he got 6, he would write down 6 on the floor. And then the next station your partner would go. We're gonna go back and forth, 12 minutes. You're gonna get 4 minutes to transition, and then you're gonna hit the next station for a total of 12 minutes.